With intent to destroy, 2 counts of attempted murder by ingestion, 1 count of grandmother impersonation, 4 counts of attempted sheep abduction, and 17 counts of lurking. And then in a mistrial, the result of a giant falling on the jury room while they were determining the verdict. Now, a number of parties have filed a class action lawsuit against Mr. Wolf in order to seek monetary compensation for what they feel has been an infringement on their rights. It seems the counsel for the plaintiffs, the unequal Miss Fairy Godmother, has arrived with one of her clients, Miss Little Red Riding Hood, and the client's grandmother, Mrs. Grandmother. Hello, Miss Fairy Godmother. Any words for EFN?
Mr. Wolf is a depraved, cold, calculating killer, and it is only his celebrity status in this force that has saved him from the hands of criminal justice. His behavior is reprehensible and has completely infringed upon my client's rights to live happily ever after. As you know, I have always fought to ensure that the good people of this forest get the ending they deserve.
Now, that wolf is gonna get it! We're gonna strip him up by his nose and shake him till all of his money falls down right here! And then, me and Granny are gonna get ourselves some nice new clothes out with him all, and then we're here!
That is enough
for me to
keep your fun live television. And we don't want to waste anyone's time. Besides, we can't have this train going on forever, you know? That's because it's good about his flirt. Well, I'll turn you to flames after midnight tonight.
Well, that's lame! You stink!
Oh, well, I never...
She grateful
is... Well, there you go! Well, thanks, but
yeah,
I didn't say
anything. You're Sydney Grimm, aren't you? Remember me? You covered Mr. World of Lumberjack pageant last year.
Yeah, well, I know I'm best in flannel and most ruggedly.
Yeah. Sure is good to see you again.
Yes, Mr. Woodcutter? Nice to see you again, too. Ready for this year's pageant, are you?
I sure am.
I'm an old shepherd, and this here's my boy. He don't know his manners too well, you see? And, I'm so old I kind of forget my things here. But, we don't want no trouble. We don't want no trouble. All we're asking is for a little money so that we can get some payment for some sheep that we lost and to pay the medical bills for my boy.
Oh, so it must be the boy who cried.
Whoa. Yeah, that's right. What did you get? Look, I was just having a little fun, all right? Like frying ants with a magnifying glass. Or blowing up squirrels with explosives.
Now, shut up there, boy. Shut up. He didn't mean nothing by that. He's a little, boys will be boys.
Right. Oh, ladies and gentlemen. The big bad wolf himself is here! The very tense moment for the problem right now. Just feel that tension! Oh, my deepest apologies, Mr. Wolf. Sydney Grimm, BFN. I will be covering the trial today.
Yeah, I guessed.
So, Mr. Wolf, who is your attorney and where is he?
She. And we don't know. Her name's, evil stepmother. You heard of her? She's some big-priced lawyer who's been dragged into pro bono work she doesn't want to do. I don't blame her. I don't stand a chance today.
Yeah. Well, you never know. Do you have anything you want to tell your viewers out there?
I got nothing to say to the world.
Thank you.
Honorable Judge Wise Old Man.
Renowned Judge Wise Old Man is presiding over the case today. Judge Mann is known for his, well, wisdom. He is known to frequently applying his gift as a philosopher to any case. And he is also known for his taste for magic beans.
Ladies and gentlemen, they say justice is blind. Well, if justice is blind and bats are blind, then that must mean that justice is a bat, eh?
Yeah!
You may be seated. In this court today, we are here to try an individual who has been accused of many heinous acts. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I want you to keep in mind this important and difficult concept that the many grueling hours of our trial. And that concept is that guilty is the opposite of not guilty, and not guilty is the opposite of guilty. Very well, shall we begin?
Sir, I have no counsel.
What? You don't have a counsel? Where's your counsel? Did you lose it? Did you check in your cushion behind the refrigerator?
No, sir.
What? You don't have a refrigerator? How do you keep your milk fresh? Oh, your lawyer. Well, who's your lawyer? Oh, she's a lot of fun. Miss Evil's stepmother.
Try to help me?
Miss Little Red Riding Hood.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth? So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
Yeah, sure. Hello, Red Deer. How are you?
Well, I'd be a whole lot better if I had that monster.
Right. Now, why don't you tell the nice people on the jury what exactly happened between you and the defendant on the day in question?
Yes, of course. Well, you see, I was walking through the woods, minding my own business, trying to get to my granny's house to get her some bread because, well, you see, she's always sick and stuff. So, you know, out of nowhere, this horrible scared wolf jumps out and pretends to be all nice and stuff. But like, I know he's creepy, so I'm like, back off, wolf. And he's like, well, no, you see, I'm all nice and stuff. Why don't you take the shortcut or whatever to get to your granny's house? So, you know, I think, well, shortcuts are good, and I hate walking. It's for losers. And I guess this wolf would just make up some shortcut or whatever. So, you know, I start walking. Turns out the freaking wolf did make it up. He gave me, like, a long gun or something, so he could get to my granny's house and eat her.
My word, he ate her grandmother.
Oh, he dressed up as my granny and got in her bed.
What? This is appalling. What sort of perverse reason do you have had for doing this?
He wanted to trick me into thinking he was my granny. And then, when I got close enough, he ate me.
Ate you too? Consumption of a live human being is a felony, ladies and gentlemen, and an obvious deprivation of one's basic human rights.
Oh, it was terrible. Until Mr. Woodcutter got out, it was all so dark and clammy and acidic in there.
Oh, it must have been horrible.
Oh, it was. Oh, I can't take it.
Why don't you just go sit back down?
Okay.
I haven't met the witness yet. But she's too sad to be questioned.
You can't do that. See, I have a right to examine this witness.
But I'm too sad! See?
Yes, well, according to Clause A of Section 12345 of the Legal Code 22F, extreme sadness may excuse a witness from further testimony.
You just made that up.
The witness is excused.
What?
You heard me. The witness is excused.
This is ridiculous.
Please sit down, Miss Stepmother. Miss Godmother, any further witnesses?
Yes, I would like to call Miss Grandmother Hood.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth? So help me, Hans Christian Andersen.
You betcha.
Right, now, tell me something.
Yes?
Are these things yours?
Why, yes. Those are my things.
And what were you wearing the day that you encountered the defendant?
Those exact same items.
Anything else?
Well, just my auntie's gear. But that's none of your business.
Now, is it not correct that when your granddaughter encountered the defendant, he was wearing those same items?
Well, none of the exact same items. I had a spare nightgown and a cap, but only one pair of glasses.
And he had eaten you at this point. That is correct.
It most certainly is.
So, not only did the big bad wolf eat you, but he made a poor old woman remove her desperately needed eyeglasses before he did so?
Yes! It was terrible!
Terrible! Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we've heard that word before. Mrs. Hood's granddaughter used the exact same words to describe the event in question. And I think they are being kind, as it is in their nature to be. So, not only did the defendant eat a grandmother and her granddaughter, but he made the poor old woman remove her much-needed eyeglasses without her ability to see the kind of psychological strain that this boy must have endured would have been unthinkable. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Wolf is a flagrant vandal and killer of sheep, not to mention a freak who likes to dress up in granny clothes and about a little old lady. You're a sick, Mr. Wolf, and it ain't gonna happen no more.
Any further witnesses?
Yes, I would like to call Mr. Bill Woodcutter. Bill!
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth? So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
I do indeed.
Now, Mr. Woodcutter, what is it that you do for a living?
Well, you see, I'm a woodcutter, which means I cut wood for a living.
As part of your job, you carry an axe, is that correct?
Yes, I do.
And are you not licensed to use this axe in cases of emergency?
I am licensed to use that axe.
Is it, in fact, not part of the woodcutter's code that you must respond to innocent people in need?
It is part of the code if I uphold that part of the code.
So, in other words, if you encounter an emergency in the forest, you are obligated to act quickly and courageously?
Yes, I am.
And so you did, sir. You're a true hero, sir.
Thank you so much.
No further questions.
Thank you, Your Honor. Mr. Woodcutter, let's talk about this woodcutter code, shall we? How do you know when there's an emergency in the woods that you need to respond to?
Well, there's not really a way to tell, but if I see something wrong, I try to respond to it.
I see. So you see it, then, do you? Well, Mr. Woodcutter, would you care to tell me what prompted you to go into Mrs. Hood's house in the day? Did you hear a scream?
No.
Did you see the defendant enter the house and become sick?
Okay, I'll snoop around the house.
Snooping! And whatever for?
I was looking for a crime to steal off the windowsill.
And why would you do a thing like that? See, I thought that you were a hero.
Well, because Honeywood don't pay so good. That's why I built the pageants in the first place. But I was so hungry.
While you were off snooping and looking to steal something, you happened to see in the window what exactly?
Oh, I saw that there wolf lying in the lady's clothes in her bed, licking his chops.
All right then. Tell me, Mr. Woodcutter, how did you know, and I mean absolutely know, for sure, that Mr. Wolf had eaten your friends and that you were justified in cutting him open? Because that is what you did, isn't it? You cut my client open with an axe, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
How did you know, Mr. Woodcutter? How did you know Mr. Wolf wasn't simply one of Mrs. Hood's friends that you didn't know? One who occasionally likes to wear her nightgowns. How did you know that he had eaten Mrs. Hood and that she wasn't simply in another room?
Well, I mean, look at him, he's a wolf.
Oh! So, you just gotta cut him open then, right? Because he's a wolf.
Yeah.
No other reason?
No other reason.
No further questions.
Well, Miss Evil
Stepmother
provides another steering cross-examination. This is very interesting!
Oh, shut up!
Miss Godmother, any further witnesses?
Yes. I would like to call the three little pigs.
Objection. You can call three witnesses at once.
Your Honor, it is essential to my case that the witnesses all be called at once.
Is it?
Well, no, but they insist on testifying together.
Your Honor, may I approach the bench?
Well, this is unorthodox, but I suppose so. Counselor, would you join us?
Stay.
Your Honor, my siblings aren't really competent to testify with them.
What do you mean?
They're immature.
No, it's okay. You can say it. They're stupid. They're stupid.
Well, I see no problem with this, Miss Stepmother.
I see no problem with it either.
Very well. May the three little pigs please approach the stand.
Let's go.
Thank you. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
Who? What? Yes, I do. Good enough. Now, would you each please give the courts your names?
Tell the nice lady your name.
My name is One.
One. Don't you mean
you don't want to get into it?
My name is Kuo.
My name is Drake.
One. Would you please tell the court about you and your house?
I had a house, then it fell down, and now I live in another house.
And what happened to your first house?
A fox blew it.
A fox? Yeah. Don't you mean a wolf? Your house.
with my parents in our childhood home up until last year when we decided to leave and build our own homes. Not too far away, but far enough to grant ourselves a reasonable amount of independence. Well, one day, that blasted, bloated, maniacal wolf came around and blew down both my siblings' houses, and they came to live with me in my house out of fear that he might eat them. We lived in such fear for such a time as he lurked outside our homes. We barely ate, we barely slept, and our personal hygiene went to the dogs. Look at all this hair on my chinny chin chin! I haven't shaved in weeks!
Oh, you poor dears! You poor dears!
Yes, it was abominable.
Ladies and gentlemen, these pigs were so scared, they couldn't even shave!
Yes, and he said he would huff and puff and blow our houses down. And he called us little pigs.
Doesn't everyone?
Yes, but he said it in a really mean, nasty sort of way that made me think he was trying to demean us. It hurt my feelings immensely.
Well, Your Honor, I have no more questions. I am too outraged with the defendant's behavior.
Yes, Stepmother.
I was going to pick on my own feet.
No. I want you to tell me what your first house was made of.
Oh, well, my first house was
made out of straw.
Straw.
Great. And
no.
I want you to tell me what your first house was made of.
That has nothing to do with me not being kosher.
Kosher!
No,
yes. What was your first house made of?
Oh, six.
Six, fantastic. And three. What was the house? The house in which you three currently reside. The one you constructed. What was it made of?
It was made out of bricks.
Right. And it hasn't fallen down by means of wolf or anything else?
No, it hasn't.
And I assume that it's up to all building codes.
Of course. What do you take me for? An animal?
Now, Bree, what about your siblings' home? Aren't sticks and straw materials approved by the zoning board?
No, they are not.
I didn't think so. How do you think your siblings' homes would have lasted in, say, a hurricane, or a tornado, or,
well, a light breeze.
Not very well.
No, but they're safe and cozy now, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
I just have one more question for you.
Yeah?
Did my client ever say that he was going to eat you?
No.
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 Then how did you know that that's what he wanted to do? How did you know that he wasn't just trying to make sure your homes were safe and secure?
Well, because...
No further questions.
The three little pigs, the witnesses are excused.
Yay!
Ms. Godmother, I need witnesses.
Yes, I have one. I would like to call Mr. Old Shepherd.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So help you, Bonds Christian Anderson.
Yes, I do.
Now, Mr. Shepherd. What is it that you do?
I'm a shepherd. I herd sheep.
And could you tell me who that boy is over there?
That's my boy. He sometimes helps me herd my sheep.
And what did he say to you one day?
Well, actually, it was three.
No. That'll be all right. Just the third day.
Let's see. Well, the boy did cry wolf, Well, the wolf ate my sheep.
I see.
Then, the people came out and, well, they started to...
Whoa, that's all right, Mr. Shepherd. That'll be all. Thank you very much. Yes,
all right.
That's all. Oh, no,
Miss Stepmother.
Mr. Shepherd, I'll be brief. Why don't you tell me what happened on the first 2 days that you mentioned?
Well, all right, then. On the first day, the boy, he cried wolf, and the village came out, and we came out to see what was happening. But there was no wolf! And then, he did the same thing on the second and the third day. No one came out because, well, we darn didn't even know what was happening.
I see. So, your boy isn't very reliable then, is he?
Well, I suppose he...
Mr. Shepherd, no one else saw Mr. Wolf steal your sheep or threaten the boy?
I don't think I...
So, the only way we can know what actually happened is by hearing what the boy has to say.
I suppose.
Your Honor, this man's testimony is essentially hearsay.
Then why are you still talking to him? Does the Council for Plantons have any further witnesses?
No.
Miss Stepmother.
Yes, the defense would like to call to the stand a surprise hostile witness. The defense calls the boy who cried wolf.
Oh boy, ladies and gentlemen, this is gonna be good.
Objection! Oh, never mind.
Come along, young man.
I don't want him.
I'm afraid you must.
Fine.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth?
Yeah, that's
so.
Good.
Tell me something, Captain. Did you on any day see a wolf today?
Yeah, of course I did. It's the third day because of the old guy. It was late one night, I was in my dream. Hey, my food is getting to the fun. Slowly now you can hardly see, but I saw that wolf right there.
What a cop!
Emergency call is a crime, young man?
Yeah, sure, but someone's always trying to ruin my fun.
Okay,
So you knew you were breaking the law when you cried wolf.
Yeah.
But wolves are not really bad.
I don't mean this from you, lady.
No further questions, sir.
Ms. Conklin, do you care to go to the witness?
Look, can I go? I gotta flush a white fish down the toilet.
No.
The witness is excused.
You know,
kid,
things might not be as bad as we thought.
Ms. Stepmother, any further witnesses?
Yes. The defense would like to call to the stand the renowned psychiatrist, Miss Muppet.
You know her!
She is the top wolf expert in the field with years of hands-on experience in the deep, dark woods.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth? So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
I don't like swearing.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You may be seated, Miss Muppet.
Oh, no.
Pardon?
I can't sit with her tuppet.
What?
Her tuppet, sir. She needs a tuppet.
Oh, a tuppet. Well, somebody go fetch her a tuppet, please.
I don't think anyone knows what that is.
Oh, thank heavens, because neither do I.
I apologize, Your Honor. She's a bit neurotic. But she's the best psychiatrist around. If you have a tuppet anywhere.
Oh, why is this taking so long?
Miss Muffer requires
a tuppet. I can sit with my tuppet.
And like that, I say, there's no such good psychiatry without this dirty tuppet. For a love that is all good and decent, what is a tuppet?
No, I think she's made it up. Why don't we just have a stand?
Very well. Miss Muppet, the state is unable to provide your so-said tuppet. Do you like stand?
My legs hurt.
Please.
Oh, well.
This is ridiculous. Just sit.
There's a spider on my chair. I need to print away. I need to print away. I need to print
away. The wise philosopher once said, curtain away, your day is okay.
Good wolf, but just kept on screaming and
He wouldn't stop, and I just kept on getting mad at him. In the blind rage, I took his sheep and scared him half to death. And I raped him that night. But after that, I tried to put my wits back together and be the nice guy that I am, but every time I encountered a creature of another species, he or she would distrust me, put it off, or just scream or something of the sort. Gradually, I didn't know how to interact with the world. I turned to a life of crime. But, okay, I did have a thing. I agree, I admit. But, please, have mercy on me. Please, I beg on you. Please, it was only what, like, oh, that's all, thank you.
When the renowned psychiatrist, Miss Muffet, revealed her true identity as the adoptive human sister of Mr. Wolf. Miss Fairy Godmother restated what her clients had said as her closing remarks, and Miss Evil Stepmother, for the defense, stated that the wolf had not been born a criminal, but made one because of the society in which he lived and believed him as such. Now, we're gonna take you back to the courtroom where they are about to deliver their final verdict.
Now, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I want you to give us a verdict.
They haven't even left the room.
Hush! No one likes jury duty. I know I didn't. All those witnesses crying, those lawyers yakking. Don't even get me started on those judges.
Wait, what? You're not going to send them to delivery?
No, we'll have them clap. It's much easier, don't you think? Now, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I want to impart some words of wisdom. Words of wisdom that may help you along your way. And now those words of wisdom are that juries are like submarine sandwiches. They are the best with mayo and hot peppers. Now then, I want all those who believe that the wolf is guilty, and is guilty with a J. Oh, with a G. That the wolf is guilty with a G, so applaud now.
Hey,
look, this is a good ending. As they say, there will always be dust in your vacuum as there will be cheese on your pizza.
How can we learn any lessons when the jury is so indecisive?
Again, unfortunately.
Oh.